Welcome to This Hope to Go. Today I want to talk to you about desperate for change. Every one of us is born with an infinite potential and an untapped purpose. Yet most people, if asked, would never tackle Mount Everest without a guide. However, so often, everyday people continue a longer, tougher expedition without the little help or support. Now, the battle for true freedom and change only comes when you begin to stand in a place and say, I'm ready. Today, we'll discover the steps we need to take if we're truly desperate for change. Looking at the life of an amazing shero, Ruth the Moabite, a great-grandmother of Jesus, whose biblical example is a textbook for all who are sincerely desperate for change and desire to live the positive, uplifting life that God truly wants us to have and experience. Now, in this Hope to Go Desperate for Change, I'm going to give you two principles that will allow you to make change if you're desperate. First principle, make a choice. Ruth 1:12 says it this way, "Turn back, my daughter. Go, for I am too old to have a husband. And if I should say that I have hope, even if I should have a husband tonight and should bear sons, would you therefore wait till they're grown?" Ruth had to make a choice to be a holy faith risk taker, a choice to kiss her mother-in-law goodbye and stay with the status quo of what was familiar, or to, by faith, go to an unknown place called Bethlehem, the house of bread, and follow her destiny. Big Hope Truth, behind every action we take is a choice. Ruth experienced true faith in action, seeing Naomi, her mother-in-law, deal with the death of her husband and her two sons. Now, Naomi didn't harbor bitterness, but by faith trusted God for her future. Faith is a choice, beloved. To follow Jesus is a choice. Big Hope action step. Like Ruth, you got to make a choice if you're desperate for change today to let go of your past and boldly move into your future. Now, if you're truly serious about change, you have to willfully choose today to kiss bye-bye to some behaviors, some beliefs, some mindsets, and also some relationships that do not embody the spirit, power, and glory of God. You got to make a choice to, by faith, grieve them and leave them, and to be a holy faith risk taker. Second principle, if you're desperate for change, commit to push through to breakthrough. Ruth 1:14, it says in the Amplified, "Then they wept aloud again, and Orpah kissed her mother-in-law goodbye, but Ruth clung to her." Ruth not only made a choice to move with her mother-in-law, she also made a commitment. Ruth surrendered her family ties and her homeland to follow God and his people. Now, that's commitment. And, you know, she was praying up a storm during this time because leaving things are not easy. Ruth willingly risked rejection and being misunderstood. Until you're truly committed, there will always be hesitancy and a chance to turn back. This is the Big Hope Truth. The moment you absolutely commit, a move of God takes place in your life. A whole chain of events begin to unleash. All kinds of unanticipated meetings, divine appointments, and material support begin to come our way the moment we make a genuine commitment. Ruth declared in 1:17, listen to this, "We will stay together until death separates us. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if anything but death separates you and me." Now, when you make this type of commitment to Jesus, good things follow. The commitment that Ruth made to her mother-in-law is similar to a commitment made in marriage by a husband and wife. Big Hope action step. Don't just settle for a breakthrough. Push through for a growth through, so you don't have to keep going back through it. Purposely put God first in everything that you do. Don't give in to the thinking that someday I'll do it. God is removing everything that stands between you and him right now. And you have to make a commitment today to do things God's way. Purpose in your heart to align your world with and affairs with his purpose. And baby, I'm telling you, the sky's the limit. You might as well put on sunglasses because your future is bright. If you believe it, hit me up on Facebook or Instagram. Say that 10 times twice and tell me, Pastor B, I'm in. And that's your Hope to Go.